Friends, members of the EAF, colleagues, I want to, you know, we have a classic starting in the European Internet Forum, which is start saying good morning and hello to our colleagues to start with. So we have a number of colleagues here. We have Mihail Boni, we have Luna Homak, we have Axel Fox. And then we have Lambert when it's right somewhere. At least it was. So, okay, he's there, yes. And so for the rest, as always, thank you very much for being here today to debate on this breakfast time on transatlantic data flows. I was commenting to one of the people sitting in this table, one of the speakers, on the context in which we are going to deal with this, which is for a number of sessions for a long time ago now. We have been debating on different angles to face, tackle the data, new currency in some way or another. The data that the dominant position that the data chain and data precedent have in all this context of development at this point of the digital world. And we have been dealing with big data, we have been dealing with cloud computing related to data as well, and so many other aspects related to Internet of Things and so on and so on. For many occasions, because I think it's a real issue related to data now, we have been debating on the angle of privacy, data protection, and so on and so. The other angle, which I think is extremely important, is to see all the opportunities in terms of the economy, possibilities in terms of business opportunities at the end of the day that we have with this phenomenon of big data circulating and the possibility of being exchanged and so on and so on. So that's mostly the angle that I would like to have today, the point of view of the business opportunity, how we can seize all the opportunities that data, big data has, and in that sense, what can we do in our transatlantic relationships, relating to this data flow? There's many data that at the same time supports these new opportunities, and for reflection on that and the other aspect that you want to really also consider. We have a number of speakers that are really experts in that. And to start with, we have Joshua Meltzer, which is the author of the report, The Importance of the Internet and Transatlantic Data Flows for U.S. and EU Trade and Investment. We will discuss the key findings of the report that Brookings Institution has prepared. Then we have René Sammer, I said in English, I don't know if it is not exactly like that, the pronunciation or not. It's Ericsson, Director, Government and Industry Relations. Then we have Marco Dwerkop, which is TTIP leader, negotiator in services, which will discuss this matter from the point of view of the European Commission. And finally, we will have as the first respondent at consumers. We have Beuk, represented here by Agustin Reina, which is senior legal officer, a digital team leader from Beuk. So that's all. So we start immediately. Please, Joshua Meltzer, the floor is yours.